This is me frowning. Oh my God, it don't even look like I'm frowning.
Katie and Peter are back. And their roller coaster love story continues.
We're working hard to make this relationship work.
I'm not doing anything.
Once again, Britain's most famous celebrity couple are giving you unprecedented access to their working life.
I've got like a sequin on my clitoris.
Family life.
One, two, three.
And their constantly talked about private life.
Get lost.
On this week's show, Katie reveals why the couple are renewing their wedding vows.
He's proved to be like a proper man, a proper husband, and I just want to do our vows again and, you know, solidify our love.
The preparations begin for the special ceremony and Kate knows exactly what she wants.
Virgin dress. I'm a virgin again and I want to look like a virgin.
And Peter turns to three-year-old Junior for inspiration.
Tell Daddy what he should say to Mummy for her wedding vows.
Loyalty.
You didn't say loyalty.
Yeah.
So sit back and relax because you won't want to miss this.
Where are you going?
Some place where you're going.
That's what I wanted to hear.
Katie's only been back at home in the UK for 2 days, but she's got just 4 weeks before jetting off to Africa, where she'll renew her wedding vows with Pete. Although she's still sore from the surgery she had during the LA trip, Kate's not done with mutilation just yet.
Today, I'm late. I'm gonna go and get the horse's bollocks chopped. And then, I mean, that's gonna be real gruesome. I've just said it casual, but it won't be. But I'm late, so hopefully I won't miss it. So let's go and cut bollocks.
It's been a while since Kate's seen her sister Sophie, so they've planned to spend the day together. Usually they'd relax in a salon or hit the shops, so witnessing this routine operation for performance stallions will be a first for Sophie.
So is the horse asleep then?
No,
awake.
They stand in there.
They do it when it's awake?
Yeah. And then Andrew said he's going to hang the balls on the door just to remind him. I think it's really interesting, don't you think?
What, so we see it all?
Yeah, I'm cutting the testicle out. You think I would have had enough of surgery and fucking bloody bollocks and fannies? About Pete last night saying he wants big ball implants. I'm like, leave it out, Pete.
No, you can't get that. Can you get
that? He says to make my package look good. I said, Pete, you've got a big knob. Yeah, but I want big balls. Because when I'm like, he said, not because I want, you know, I just want people to look at me and think, oh, I've got what a nice big package. And I'm like, well, I can see what he means because I would have been in a bikini and have like nice tits. But come on, balls.
Yeah.
I don't want a pair of plastic balls in my mouth. But then it's plastic tits, but it's different, I think, didn't you, compared to balls?
Yeah.
So, yeah, imagine me with big balls banging against you. I'm like,
oh,
yeah, that'd be great, Peter.
You got me begging you for mercy. Why won't you really?
Katie's removing the testicles from her new stallion, Andre, who she named after Peter. She spent hundreds of thousands of pounds on this frisky beast, but Andre's so full of testosterone he can't concentrate on his dressage performance. Katie and Sophie are running late and Andre has been anaesthetised, but they arrived just in time to get involved.
So am I cutting a ball off?
If you can, what I'll do is...
I'm up for anything.
No, you didn't really bring central shoes.
No, oh, yeah. Really? Oh, is there a pair of wellies or something? What about Uggs?
And I might get you to take all your...
Jewellery
off.
That's fine, I'll just go with the flow. Oh, my God.
Does he have anything?
Yeah.
This is what I've been like for the past 2 weeks in America. Zonked out, drugged up to the eyeballs.
Oh, look, bless.
Oh, what a lovely feeling that is, though, when you're like that.
He said that he's locally anaesthetised and everything, but it's just a question of safety.
Because I've had my bits done, he's copying me, he's getting his bollocks chopped. Look.
No, he didn't feel that at all.
Oh, what the hell? Oh, my God, come and look at this.
OK. Kate, go and put some shoes on.
Yeah.
You reckon?
Seriously.
Well, just in case... OK, you want to come where Andrew's standing, but we cut everything in two sections.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, can you hear that?
Right, so then we just leave those there, and we've cut one part.
So, and he really can't feel any of that?
They can still feel it up by their kidneys because of the cremaster muscle. And we've just cut that out now, so he can't... He will feel the sensation of something pulling down on him.
You could cook that up. They should do that in the jungle. Horse's testicle. Cook it up. Oh, didn't you say the dog eats it?
We put local anaesthetic into it, so it's not a good idea.
Ah.
Unless you want to cook them.
No, I'll stick to human one.
And now we take it off and we just...
What? You're pulling it?
Well, no, I'm just getting it a little bit more...
Oh! Oh, mate!
So, right, that's the first one done, and we've just got the whole testicle. There's no way that he can reproduce, and we'll lose all his
testosterone. Bloody hell.
So I'll just get rid of that.
Wow!
Katie's no stranger to surgical procedures, but this time she fancies being the one making the nips and tucks.
I'll get the other testicle ready for you.
I really appreciate you letting me do this.
Well, I
love anything like
Laura,
this.
Laura, my student, who's missing out because she was going to do it.
Oh, sorry.
No, she'll do it. She can do the next one.
But no, it's brilliant. I'm ready to clamp away. How cruel must people think? I'm not cruel at home, by the way. I just want to be part of it because it's my new baby. And it's the learning, you know, it's nature. See, that doesn't make me go woo or nothing. Is that... Does it? Yeah, it doesn't. Some people be really squeamish at that.
What I want you to do is hold those. And we'll just get those clippy things around. Now, above, they're quite heavy. So I want you to put those around there like a pair of scissors. Open up. Go up as high as you can.
Yeah.
Now close them. Close them. Yeah, just hold those and just keep them going. Right, you can let those go now. Let them go and just drop down. Oh. Here we are.
Oh my God, I'm going to have to go home and get changed.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Now that was your fault, wasn't it?
No. Bollocks, literally. Oh, I was going to hold the testy, but I won't now, just to feel the weight. Oh no, I've got what? Oh no, got blood on me now.
Coming up, Katie sees her first pictures since the cosmetic treatments.
You don't see them because you're going to want more surgery if you see them.
Surgery? No, that's what the problem is. Duck. I'm like that.
The couple go in search of the perfect wedding vow outfits.
Oh.
I don't know if just this on its own just looks special enough.
But will there be a ceremony at all?
I don't trust him 100%. I would never trust him.
I trust you.
It's the 27th of August and Katie and Peter have got just under 2 weeks to cram in all their work commitments before flying off to South Africa.
What's he doing there?
He's going to, with VG's, doing a charity thing. You can go with him if you want.
The phones have been ringing with booking inquiries and they're not just for our celebrity couple.
How do you feel about them princess modelling for Prima Baby?
Brilliant.
First little job.
Started younger than me. At least she's not doing topless.
Princess might have scored her first job, but this seasoned professional has her eye on the next project.
Today I'm doing press shoots for my perfume. I'm still sore, but I've got to start doing some work. I've had 3 weeks off. Enough's enough now, I've got to get back to work. So I'm just in dresses and whatever today. Easy day. Right, what am I wearing first?
It's
fucking cold.
Outside.
What am I doing outside first?
Silver dress, yeah, outside.
Oh my God. You can't film this because I've got no knickers on. I'm not even kidding, I can't.
This is the first shoot after she's had her surgery and she can't lift her boobs up to put her boobs into the dress. She can't lift her arms up because obviously the muscles under her arms are quite sore.
That looks awful, doesn't it?
But she's trying not to moan, funny for Kate, but you can see that she's just a bit awkward the way she's holding herself. I don't think she's going to be right for at least another month yet.
It isn't too bad, to be fair.
That'd be all right, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Makes me shake when I look at them like that, because it... I'm still bumble and they're really sore and I can't force them in cleavage. I'm too sore. It's all about lips today.
Don't push your lips out anymore, love.
Am I?
Just pull them in. Can't control your face anymore.
I can the bottom half. I feel like a bubble face, look. I feel right each day, better and better.
It's
just twisting, like that, them shots. With my boobs like that, they're vulnerable, but it's fine. No one would know, it's cool. Why only you guys at home watching will know.
In true Pricey style, Kate's battling on through her first day back at work.
Yeah, I'm sore, but I'm coping. The pictures would be fine. And my lips don't look as big now because I've got eye makeup on, but... Oh, well, whatever. At least I can admit it.
Do you like your lips?
I love my lips. Yeah. Don't you? I can't even do that. My... God, it don't even move. I'm trying to raise my eyebrows, don't you? Does it look like I'm raising them, really? This is me frowning. Oh, my God, it don't even look like I'm frowning. And I'm really trying. Right, now I'm squinting. Does it not even look like I'm squinting? It doesn't. That's what you call proper Botox. No frowning, raising eyebrows or squinting. They've done a bloody good job because they freezed me. Brilliant. But I haven't had it all here. I had a bit of filler here because when I smiled, I had like wrinkly bits. So I had filler. I don't think I'm going to rush to do that again because that fucking hurt. I mean, hurt. So, yes, so I've got Botox here, tiny bit to there, Botox there, filler here, and I had my lips plumped. Yes, ladies at home, you're saying, see, she's not real, she's all fake. Yes, big deal, so what, woo. Oh my God, what's happening with that bag?
Get that sorted out, well, straight away.
Bloody hell.
That's gonna be dealt with.
So I don't really see on airbrush and I can't bear it.
Fucking hell.
Vile. Honestly, I've got a beak. I've got a beak.
Don't see them because you're going to want more surgery if you see them.
Surgery? No, that's what the problem is. I'm like that. Awful.
Don't see them, but you don't look like that in real life.
Oh, I do. I never know what the real picture is. I'm like that. Gross.
It's the next day and Peter's turn to get dressed up. He's at the fashionable New King's Road in West London with the big day in mind.
I'm here to try on a suit for my wedding vows because we're redoing the wedding vows for a simple reason that Kate didn't feel happy on the day we got married, which doesn't sound great, does it? But she reckons she was going through postnatal depression at the time, which she was. So she wants to redo the vows to show her love for me, which I really greatly appreciate, and I want to show my love to her. G'day, g'day, g'day.
It's not just an important day for Pete. Across town, Katie's shopping for a glamorous handmade wedding dress at a boutique she visits when looking to stand out in a crowd.
Oh!
Would you like a cup of coffee?
I'd love a cup of tea, please.
Tea? Okay.
Milkshake. And one more thing, you'll probably hate me.
No.
Can I have the aircon off if I'm trying to dress
off? Yeah, I know, I always put it off.
Frozen.
I'm
so happy that you came because we have completely new.
Wicked. I only had my boobs done a couple of weeks ago, so I am sore, so I won't be able to try on everything, but I'll try on enough. A lot. Yeah, I still try on a lot. So I love the dresses in here.
Kate and Peter's wedding day was a flamboyant affair, but Pete's decided against a hand-tailored morning suit and is going for an informal off-the-peg number.
So what do you reckon? You got white?
Yeah, full. Got the white linen suit.
Yeah, that's nice.
And that combination there, the floral print and the black tie. Okay. The waistcoat. And
that's nice. I mean, I'm thinking all white. I'm not thinking a shirt with patterns on it. Like, that's really cool, but I just don't know for the vows if that's what I want, that's all. I want it to be less formal than the last one. I want to be, like, smart, but I also want to be kind of casualed out a bit. Because it's the renewing of the vows, it's not the wedding day, even though she may be wearing, like, a wedding dress. I don't know, to me, it's just more about being comfortable. The first day is like everything's proper in the tie, and I just, you know. I've got no underwear on.
Shit.
I never do, dude.
You serious?
Free flow, is that bad?
For us, yeah.
Well, no, because I'm clean and I'm Greek. I don't know if just this on its own just looks special enough. I don't know, and I'm being honest. I don't know if it just looks a bit...
While Peter might be having second thoughts about the casual look, Katie knows exactly what she wants.
Big Cinderella dress, virgin dress. I'm a virgin again, and I want to look like a virgin.
Having given birth to three adorable kids, a virgin look will be difficult to pull off. But thankfully, there's an abundance of sparkling, colourful dresses to choose from.
Very rich.
Kate's been shown some fabulous gowns, but nothing's caught her eye. When up the stairs comes the dress of all dresses.
I'm gonna love it, and
I thought about this. This is what was in my mind. Because I know it will look amazing on
her. Yeah, see, that is more like it. How gorgeous is that?
Yeah, this looks so theatrical.
I love the gold, though. What colours do you do that in? This gold?
Gold looks the best.
I prefer that elf, all of them, for the wedding. But they can't do the zip up because it's broke.
Yeah, I think it's still
nice. Don't you think?
Yeah, good gemma.
I do like that.
Good gemma.
Beautiful. I do like it in gold.
It's lovely in gold.
What? It's not. What do you think?
She doesn't have to wear white or ivory, does she?
Where are they actually getting
the
diamonds?
Sounds like a wear, like inside, outside. Where?
Oh,
I believe it's outside.
This would probably blend in with that, then, wouldn't it?
Colour scheme.
Yeah.
Katie's not the only one considering going against the colour scheme, because with underwear on this time, Pete's trying to jazz up his look too.
Thanks. Maybe it's a bit too much, but I do like the idea of it, though. Something kind of cool about it. OK, so we go classic.
Go classic, yeah.
I'm leaving it to you. We go classic. We've decided to go class. But do you think a tie... I should have an option of a tie.
Yeah.
Have a white tie.
For the pictures, definitely.
I'll go white.
Yeah, go white.
OK. Fine, done.
Yeah.
Pete's decided on his dapper wedding vow threads, but Katie's had a change of heart and has rejected the glitzy gold.
Also, I wouldn't wear a white skirt, but it's a purple top. It just seems okay. Nice. Just
so what happened? Yeah. So it will look like one piece, really.
Oh, I love it.
Just like with four.
And that's gorgeous. They can do this in white and that.
No, that is gorgeous.
What do you think?
That's the gold one.
Do you?
No.
But could you get this in white?
I think it's
really silver.
Yeah, silver, you could.
Yeah, silver and white, I want to call them now. But the size is good.
I absolutely love that.
You're happy with the dress size? You feel comfortable?
I think it fits perfect.
At a little under 10 grand, this two-piece combination is way off the £100,000 price tag of Kate's original wedding dress. However, it's the perfect choice for a more intimate affair.
Do you know, if I'm honest, even Pete said he wants me in white. He has said it, I'm only being honest. I like the gold, but this is more wedding-y.
So is there time to make that then?
I'll ring the factory immediately.
Yeah, that is
green one.
I even love the back, didn't you, Jamila? Love the back of it. Perfect. I don't even want to take it off. Love it.
Now, what's the latest we can have the dress?
Well, these guys fly out the country on the 8th of September on an evening flight. So, really, to pick it up the morning
of the 8th.
So that I can make sure that it's to them and ready to go. Nothing like a challenge.
You know what the thing with this dress?
It's all handmade.
Wow.
The whole dress is handmade.
Yeah. All right, we'll start.
So that's one more thing ticked off the vows to-do list. But Kate's still struggling with the after effects of surgery, and a few hours later she arrives for an important appointment.
Hiya, nice to meet you.
And you.
Come in.
Katie lost the feeling of her right arm in Los Angeles and has been advised to see a physiotherapist for treatment.
Excellent. How are you feeling?
I'm fine, because I've literally got back and it's this arm. Now I've noticed it hurts me when I push, it feels like a car's gone into me.
How long has it gone now since you had your surgery?
3 weeks on Monday.
3 weeks is so short still.
But the question is, in October, I've got a really big horse show and I have to be able to do
dress
it.
Dress such stuff.
Yes. And but if you know about horses, horse theatre shows.
I do, yeah.
Well, there you go. And but I'm all right pulling, but I don't know.
How long was your anaesthesia?
Well, I had 5 proper anaesthetics.
Yeah, over what
8
time?
Days.
8 days, yeah. That's quite an anaesthesia.
Tell me about
it. So they sit on your nerve endings and you just have to detox. But 3 weeks is very fresh. You know, you want miracles.
Always. Cover my belly.
I will.
When Katie gets the bit between her teeth, there's no stopping her, especially when it comes to her love of dressage.
You've been through things, eh?
Yes. And I've just bought a horse in Holland. That's why I asked where you're from.
Yeah, that's where I'm from.
So I've just bought a stallion from over there.
But a stallion has a mind of its own, eh?
Yeah, I've just said its balls done, actually.
Your shoulders are not as yet ready to hold an enormously strong animal like that through whatever movement you're going to put it through, so be very careful, eh?
Do you ride? You sound like you ride.
No, my partner has dressage center here.
Oh, really? How weird is that?
Louise, yeah. But Katie, you be careful, eh? You are a little restricted there through some adhesions, but it'll come good.
Oh, good.
And come down a bit. There we relax.
This physio will have to pull out all the stops if Katie's going to be fit for her upcoming performance at the Horse of the Year show.
Well, I'm on a fair ride.
Later that day, our celebrity couple's schedule includes a series of telephone interviews at manager Claire's offices. But Kate's already started and Pete's missed the first call.
G'day, everyone.
G'day.
The hacks are always hungry to hear what our saucy couple have been up to, and these meetings are an opportunity to set the record straight.
G'day.
Hey. Not naked, is he?
No, he's not naked, he's dressed.
How do you guys keep the romance alive then? Because you're both so massively busy.
We just love each other.
Is that do you
and we're very cuddly as well.
Yeah.
When her boobs aren't sore.
What did you say?
No, he didn't say anything, Nick. Don't worry.
Well,
we just crack on.
Do you have any regrets ever about being in the series?
No.
You wouldn't change anything?
Obviously you get some days where you can't be asked to be filmed.
Yeah.
And you have to be. But that's natural of any job, you know. If you've got an office job, sometimes you're like, oh, I really can't be asked to get on the train, to go up. That's like of any job and you still have to do it.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's not really hard work. It's hard work in the way that when the cameras are on, you're still being filmed. Not that you act, but you're still being filmed, you know. You could be picking your nose and you'd think, oh, shit, I'm being filmed picking my nose. You know, it could be anything.
Yeah. You have to breathe in sometimes.
Well, yeah.
We've got a good team around us, actually.
Right, well, I wish you the best of luck with the new
Thank
series.
You.
Great to have you running your vows as well.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You can't do that.
She didn't think
line.
She meant to do it that quickly.
She did. So what do you want? Oh, no, I'm not going to eat tonight.
Do you want me to cook something?
No, because you cook fattening food. I can't have fattening food.
You're not fattening food.
What have you eaten today?
Nothing.
Coffee.
I've had two coffees.
And you're not going
to
eat tonight?
No, but last night I ate, and I don't like to eat.
You can't not eat.
No, no, I eat one meal a day, usually.
So what are you saying you're not eating today?
Peter doesn't eat. That's the real truth. I've definitely got the wrong partner.
Katie, I recently read that you hate your body. Do you have any comments for that?
Yeah, they're a bunch of so I've got nothing to say. I wish they'd write something true, then they might get an interview.
Ever the honest Kate, eh?
No, I like it. You guys are obviously so busy. Do you have to kind of schedule time to spend time together to be romantic?
I honestly think the times to do that is just when you go away together, really.
And we're doing our wedding vows in 2 weeks anyway.
Oh, wow. Good luck with that.
Thank you.
Any special reason?
Yeah, because I wanted to, and I wanted to change my name.
And for everything else.
Your name, are you?
Yeah, to Andre, because I haven't done it.
Oh, wow. Is there any particular reason now?
Because I wasn't really, like, on our wedding day, I had postnatal depression. I didn't enjoy it as much as Pete. And, you know, I've put him, he's proved to be, like, a proper man, a proper husband. And I just want to do our vows again and, you know, solidify our love.
Oh, that's really nice. I mean, I remember in an interview we did with you a while back, you said that you were never sure you trust any man 100%.
I don't trust him 100%.
No?
No.
Why not?
It doesn't mean to say I can't do my way. I would never trust
him. I trust you.
Well, then you're a mug.
Am I?
So I don't trust you.
Okay. Well, there you go. That's a bit of love there, isn't it?
Oh.
A bit of reality.
I don't think any woman should trust anyone.
She's going to see that. She's going to say, so basically the interview was a lie.
Not a lie.
But I love you. And I do trust you.
Well, I don't trust you.
Are we done?
I don't.
Well, what's up with you, man?
I just don't.
You're being snappy.
Right, well,
I don't trust you 100%. You know that. I would never trust any man 100%.
Time with the two of them now, so we can
better start trusting your husband.
And then Pete can just do his last one.
Coming up, Pete struggles to find the perfect words to declare his undying love.
How do you write vows? I mean, what do you say?
Just go on the internet.
Yeah.
And look up a Barry White song.
Kate paints the pony world pink.
That's not just all Wellington boots, joppers and a T-shirt. That's just so boring.
And Junior's giving Peter the heebie-jeebies.
I think you're an older man in a young person's body. You're freaking me out.
Katie and Peter have got 5 days to get their work out of the way before leaving for the trip of a lifetime to the African bush. So it's an early start in North London where businesswoman Katie is press launching her latest venture.
It's all about the horse stuff today. Gary's late, as usual. I'm on time because it's to do horses.
Yeah.
Oh, you are here?
Gary is here.
Today, she's promoting her new equestrian range that she hopes will dazzle the formal world of horse riding. Her brother Dan is on hand to cover the day for her website, but he seems a little out of his depth.
Being a completely non-horsey person, I think that's what the year's saddle goes on. All will be revealed in a whip.
Katie has dreamed up the whole look for today's photo shoot, and she won't be the only star on show. Her co-model for the day has arrived, and Kate wants her to look the part too.
You can say no if you like. I've got proper horse pink hoof stuff.
Yes.
Would you mind me painting her toe?
No, not at all. No, that's fine.
That's all I was going to ask.
She's got new shoes on, especially
for you. Oh, really? And I've just proper, I ordered it, like, it's proper hoof. I've never seen it before, but it's for horses, so.
No, that would be quite sweet.
Brilliant. And then I've got these heart stencils, but then if she's got the rug on, you won't need them, so. Excellent. Thank you for doing this. I can change the world with my
own two. In the heart of the home counties, Pete and Junior are learning more about a fair trade organisation who have asked Pete to be an ambassador.
Organic rose sugar. Whoo, that smells good. Take your dummy out, please. Smell it. You do it.
What's in here?
Mexican honey.
Ooh.
Oh, that's some powerful stuff.
I want to smell it. Ooh.
You're funny, man. Just say whatever, Dad. My aim is by next year to go to South America and to actually go and meet some of these traders and see how they do it and go and see, pick a few coffee beans myself. I'm too obsessed with coffee, I've got to get over it.
As Pete and Junior get stuck into some goodies, Katie and her modelling partner are being made up for the shoot.
The horsey thing, you can be glamorous at it as well. It's not just all Wellington boots, joppers and a T-shirt. That's just so boring. Some women who are glamorous probably want to be a bit glam around the horses. They might want to impress the farmer.
I sense a book coming on.
Might be like, what's her name, Jackie Collins?
Jilly Cooper,
that's it. That's quite a good idea, isn't it?
And of course, the storyline and the plot will come from your previous experience back in the day.
Exactly. So it's no joppers, it's a horse with pink nail varnish on, glitter. Well, hey, there you go. Proper Barbie set. That is it, Barbie? When I was young, I used to play with Barbie in the horse and carriage and I'm bringing it to life. My dream to life.
While Katie's living out her childhood fantasies, Peter's searching his soul. It's only words, and words are all... With the couple due to reaffirm their love in a matter of days, Pete's keen to get his vows written.
I've got a feeling this time she might get a bit emotional. I don't know why, maybe not. But I was really emotional in the last one. I mean, my God. All you had to do was put a bra on me and I would have been the woman, that's for sure. I've got a feeling maybe this time let her be the one going, I love you. And me going, I know. And her going, but Pete, I love you. Yeah, I know. Yeah, but Pete, you're the world to me. That's cool. No, Pete, please show me love. I like you lots. No, Pete. Tell me you're in love with me. Kate, you know, man, you know. No, say it. It. Come on, Pete. Just say it. It. Pete, don't take the piss. What? Just say you love me. You love me. Pete, don't fucking take the piss. And this is what she was doing to me. Like, it was a lot of that kind of game at the start. Pete, do you love me? Don't need to answer that. You know the answer. Can you just answer it? What? Just tell me you love me. You love me. And then it goes on. And then there's like, it turns to hatred. You're an arsehole. Oh, I'm an arsehole now. Yeah, you're an arsehole. Well, a minute ago you loved me. Now I'm an arsehole. Yeah, you're an arsehole because you don't tell me you love me. And it goes on. And then eventually, we kiss and make up. And then we go upstairs and we do naughties.
Well, it seems Pete's got more work to do on his vows, but thankfully the press launch is trotting along nicely. One of the models is ready and waiting, but the other seems to be fashionably late.
Right, I'm going now, guys. Stop that for now.
Katie's idea to model with a horse is going down well with the Paps, but perhaps she's unaware of the old saying, never work with animals. At least Katie doesn't have to worry about cleaning up the mess, but it seems she needs reassuring after her modelling partner's bowel movement.
How did that look?
Really good. Really good.
Well done.
Did that look good?
Fabulous.
Did it look good?
Absolutely
really
brilliant.
I think, no, I was trying to go...
Don't you think? I thought it looked really brilliant. And the colours, really your shoes matched her toes.
Oh, really? Just,
yeah, it was fantastic.
Yeah.
Thanks very much, thanks.
Katie's day has been a success, but things aren't going as well for Pete. He's turned to his brother Mike for a haircut and some vital inspiration.
This is a bit kind of personal, and I know it's not the right time to do it while you're cutting my hair, but what do you reckon? I've never written
a vow.
Wedding vows. I mean, we added respect in our last one, but how do you write vows? I mean, what do you say?
Just go on the internet.
He
Yeah.
And look up a Barry White song.
Oh, you're my first, my last, my everything.
You're my first, my last, my everything.
I like that.
Yeah.
Why don't I go for
Barry White has the best lyrics.
Barry White.
For anything.
Go Bazza. Did you hurt your foot?
Yeah.
Were you being a plonker? Junior, tell Daddy what he should say to Mummy for her wedding vows. Take them. So I should just say la 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 la. I'm sick of writing those kind of songs, Junior. See? What a song. I know. Junior, listen to me. If you had a girlfriend, take your dummy out for a sec. If you had a girlfriend, what would you say to her?
Loyalty?
You didn't say loyalty.
Yeah.
No, you did not.
Loyalty.
That has just freaked me out, everyone. Jables, did you just say loyalty? What about trust? What are you laughing at that for? Junior, did you just say love will never die?
Yeah.
Okay, my son's freaking me out now, guys.
Never die.
Never die. That's right, son. I think you're an older man in a younger person's body. You're freaking me out. Loyalty and love will never die. That's very good. Junior, you've just inspired me, son. What do you mean, you know? Love will never die. He's freaking me out. Do 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 do. Junior, what about faithfulness? No, eh? Why are you laughing?
Coming up, a brand new love story begins as Katie and Peter fly off to South Africa to renew their vows.
Where are you going?
Same place where you're going.
That's what I wanted to hear.
Today's the 8th of September, the day that Katie and Peter are jetting off to South Africa, where they're hoping to renew their wedding vows in the open savannah. The builders are in to fit a stylish new kitchen, but despite the chaos and clutter around the house, Pete's only thinking about love.
If she wants to reinstate her love to me, fine, I'm happy, because I love her anyway, so it doesn't bother. And I know I looked away and it looked like I was lying, because I went, that's fine, because I love her too, but I'll do it again. Basically, I love her anyway, 150,000%, so it doesn't bother me redoing the vows. Again, because I'll tell her every day anyway that I love her. Bit of a miserable cow sometimes, but I love her.
The kids will be staying at home with Granny and the nannies because this trip is about Katie and Peter rekindling their romance. Just a few weeks ago, the couple were barely talking, but they're determined that the renewal of their vows will offer them both a fresh start.
What we've agreed to do, probably the best thing ever, is we've agreed to go without our telephones. This is probably the biggest step forward for us. I'm not saying that we needed to go a step forward, but what a commitment, both of us, to not take our phones, because when I'm on the phone, she's always thinking, who's he texting, who's he calling, and when she's on the phone, I think the same. So not having that means we haven't got that to think about, we haven't got that to argue about, so I think it's going to be amazing. I'm really looking forward to it, actually. Really am. So, ciao.
It's never easy to say goodbye to the kids, but Pete does his best to explain why they're leaving.
Look, Daddy and Mummy are going to renew their love. Now, you don't understand what that means, but it just means it's better for all of us.
Whoa!
What?
Come
As they arrive at the airport, Katie keeps Peter guessing whether or not she's brought her favourite accessory.
Duh.
Oh, I have got one for them.
Honestly, have you? Just be honest.
I have.
Really?
My case.
Why didn't you tell me?
I'm not going to turn it on.
Why didn't you tell me? And then I would have... She's staring me. She's a cow. Are you serious or not? Oh, come on now. Don't do that, because I could have bought mine, and I didn't. Don't be silly, all right?
Kate might be winding Pete up about bringing a mobile phone, but as soon as they approach first class, their excitement begins to build.
Hello, everyone.
Is brilliant.
With their bags checked in, it seems Katie and Peter only have eyes for each other, and it's not long before they're playing one of their favourite games.
My love is pure. I saw an angel of that, I'm sure. She smiled at me on the subway. She was with another man.
Hi, how are you? Sorry, do you mind if I sit down?
No, come sit here.
Thanks, yeah.
Do you want me to move up?
No, that's okay.
Have you flown first before?
Sorry. Sorry, I did you say a joke? Sorry, I didn't.
No, I just said, have you flown terminal before?
Yeah.
Are you here with?
I was supposed to be meeting someone here, but they haven't turned up.
Where are you going?
How about I answer your question with a question? Where are you going?
Same place where you're going.
That's what I wanted to hear.
As long as I get a diamond ring.
I fucking will buy you a diamond ring, you'll see. Don't make me fall fucking head over heels crazy again.
What?
You know what, and then you just be like, oh, it's too much, too much. Don't do that.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm going to be really loving on this trip, and if you, you know...
You're getting hard. Why do you get hard on so...
No.
So quick?
I know.
But why? It's all in the price
love,
you kiss.
Love.
Just one kiss and you get a hard on. Does it really give you a hard on just the kiss? Well, it does most men, I suppose. Just think, that's my wedding blouse dress and actual suit. Are you ready? Do you want to have a little peek at it?
No.
Claire, can I just have the bag for it? I'm not showing the whole outfit of my dress.
I'm not going to have a look at
it. I'm not letting him look. I just want to peek into it, just a little reminder.
Oh, come
you
on.
You lot at home can open it.
This happened to me at
the
wedding.
They've done that better.
Done. Another peek. Just at the colour. Just show me a bit of colour.
Okay, you can see the colour.
Also, we're very similar.
Very.
Ooh, I like it a lot.
Right, come on, let's go. We're missing shopping time, you two.
Mind my hair, mind my tits. You can't even look.
Oh, my boots, get off my tits.
If you can use some exotic booze...
Right, I think she weighs a bit more than the recommended dose.
Hey.
Actually, let me see how much you do weigh. It's 52 kilos.
Oh, my God, I've put on weight.
Yeah, but you're wearing clothes. What about me?
Sorry.
I've got clothes on though, loads of clothes on.
88.
I can't be, I'm 78 kilos.
No, it's on here, it says 80.6.
Well, let's go. Thanks very much. Next time you're going to see us is in South Africa, so we'll say see you later. For now, we'll see you there.
No, the next time you'll see me was when I'm with the Rangers.
No,
attack
the next
with the gun.
Time you see her, she'll be Mrs. Andre.
Come on, guys.
Oh, shit, I forgot about that. Is that what I'm here for? I thought I was here to go on a safari.
Let's go.
Come fly with me, let's fly, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away.
Coming up on next week's Katie and Peter, the next chapter. It's the big day in South Africa and love is in the air.
For all her stress that she gives me, I love her more now than I ever did.
I love you too.
But will Katie survive the ceremony?
Very cold. You're in a suit. You'll be very warm. I'll be very cold in my minimal outfit.
And could the weather spoil all of the plans?
It's cold and it looks like it's going to rain.
I'm retired. That's what I told the client.
No, I don't want to do it.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
You know where I am if you change your mind.
It's Secret Diary of a Cool Girl next, and then at 10:30...
I mean, honestly, it's not even that heavy. OK, I'm a cape.
It's No Heroics on ITV2.